All right, everyone, let's get it going. Michael, what do you got?
I mean, Andre Johnson, you don't know much about him because he doesn't talk a whole lot. And this is a guy who never knew his father, and one of his closest friends was killed. His teammate had a son before he died, and now Andre is the godfather to that young man. And he's trying to give his godson what he didn't have and what was taken from him.
Ten-year-old Cyril Jones Jr. is just learning the defensive tackle position.
Good tackle, Cyril!
Good coming off the ball so slow.
He's getting tips from a pretty knowledgeable source. Texans wide receiver Andre Johnson, who's also Cyril Jr.'s godfather.
What kind of tips does he give you? Does he tell you about being a good player? What does he tell you?
He told me to shoot through my gaps faster so I sat the quarterback.
It works?
Uh-huh.
Good.
Johnson is in his hometown of Miami, watching Cyril Jr. for the first time this season, because on most Friday nights, he's preparing to put on a show on Sunday.
13-yard touchdown pass to the best wide receiver in the NFL, Andre Johnson.
A four-time Pro Bowler, the 6'3", 225-pound Johnson posted consecutive seasons of 100 catches and 1,500 yards in 2008 and 2009.
Where do you feel you rank among the players in the league?
To me, I feel like I'm the best.
That's the most trash talk I'm gonna get from you.
I said I wouldn't feel that way until I was able to put the numbers up, you know, to prove it. So right now, yeah, I feel like I'm the best at what I do.
The 29-year-old Johnson grew up minutes from where the Dolphins play their home games. He was raised by his mother, Karen, and met his father only once.
I think it was about in the third grade. Came in from school and he says, "Mom, I saw my dad today, you know." I was like, "Really?" He said, "Yeah." So I said, "Well, what do you guys talk about?" He said, "Well, he act like he didn't know me, so I act like I didn't know him." And that was the end of that relationship.
It just left a bad taste in my mouth. So I was just kind of like, well, if he don't want to deal with me, I don't, you know, have to deal with him.
Karen Johnson worked full-time at the post office while raising two sons. She taught Andre to be tough at a young age.
I do remember one time we were playing flag football, and I had left my cleats at home, and I'm sliding all across the field, and I was just kind of out of the game. I was crying, and she just came out on the field at halftime and, like, jacked me up in front of everybody.
Did you get the message?
I looked like a new player in the second half of the football game, so I definitely got the message.
Andre went on to star at Miami Senior High School, where he also met fellow wide receiver Cyril Jones, who quickly became his closest friend.
He was a funny dude. I don't know what it was. Me and him just kind of bonded.
Andre was one of the most highly touted prospects in the nation and chose to attend the University of Miami. Cyril, meanwhile, earned a four-year football scholarship to Carson Newman College in Tennessee, but he was homesick and soon returned to Miami.
What was he doing when he came home?
He was just kind of caught up into the street life.
Cyril had several run-ins with the law, but kept that part of his life from Andre. On Andre's 19th birthday, July 11th, 2000, Cyril had a son, Cyril Jr. Father and son were regulars at Andre's games that fall.
You see a lot of, you know, young guys that, you know, don't get involved in their son's life. He was very involved in his son's life.
As a sophomore, Andre led Miami with 5 touchdowns, and the Hurricanes were the nation's top-ranked team.
Deep down the sideline, Andre Johnson, touchdown Miami!
On November 1st, 2001, Andre and Cyril spoke on the phone, as they did each week leading up to game day.
We were on the phone for probably about 2.5, 3 hours. We talked about everything we did together in high school, and he was like, "I'm gonna call you back when you get out of practice." I get a phone call, answer the phone, I'm like, "What's up, man?" And it was silent. And then you can hear his mom, so I'm like, "Hello?" And she was like, "Dre, he's dead."
According to police reports, an argument had turned deadly, and Cyril was murdered, shot dead at 20. Cyril Jr. was just 1.5 years old.
A couple of weeks later, Cyril Jr.'s mother called.
All right.
Tell me about that phone call.
She asked me, would I be his godfather?
He's a very good person. He's very responsible. Cyril knew him as a father figure.
I told her, yeah, you know, I would do it. I wouldn't want little Cyril to grow up the same way I grew up without my father.
8 months after Cyril was murdered, Andre learned that his own father had been shot and killed.
I never cried about nobody dying until my father had passed. I guess it was just me releasing, you know, all the stuff that had built up.
Today, Andre Johnson is trying to be the father he never had. He and his girlfriend have a 1-year-old daughter named Kylie, and Andre continues to be the only father Cyril Jr. has known. Andre occasionally flies Cyril Jr. to Texans home games, but during the season, they mostly talk on the phone. When he's home in Miami, he's able to spend more time with Cyril and help keep his godson in line.
What happened on that one?
Cyril got in trouble in school, and so I told his mom, I was like, let's just drive up to the school.
Everybody's being quiet. Cyril's the only one jumping up, running around the class.
I walked in the door. His eyes looked like, his eyes got big.
What'd you think when he walked into school?
I was in trouble.
We took him home, and I probably sat there for about 3 hours, just telling him about, you know, what he needs to do, you know, what he shouldn't do.
In October, during the Texans' bye week, Andre made it back to Miami to prep Cyril Jr. in his last game before the playoffs.
You're making tackles, but you're coming off the ball for soft, though.
You'll play in the NFL one day?
Yep.
You'll be a defensive lineman?
Wide receiver.
Wide receiver? Why you gonna play wide receiver? Because somebody you know plays wide receiver?
Mm-hmm.
Andre always did everything, you know, a father figure does for Cyril. Foz, you know, mentally, financially, however, he was there for Cyril. If it wasn't for Andre, I don't know where Cyril would be right now.
There you go.
You just try to make sure you're there, checking on him. Right now, I really don't think he still understands it. But I think once he gets older, he will.